Hi, welcome to the Macworld video. I'm Chris Breen. You know, lately I've seen people playing around with these things while they're driving, and I can't tell you what a terrible idea that is. I mean, not only is it difficult to find what you're looking for when you're driving around in your car, but there's a very real possibility that you could get yourself killed, or worse yet, kill me because you've swerved into my lane when you're mucking around with that iPod. Add to that the fact that we've had some fairly treacherous weather lately and you've compounded the problem. With all that in mind, I've decided to devote this video to driving with your iPod without getting killed. Buckle up. The safest way to play your iPod in your car is to never put music on it that you don't like, and then shuffle that music. One way to do this is to rate your music and then create a smart playlist based on those ratings. You can rate music in iTunes main window for individual tracks, or you can select a bunch of tracks, press Command-I, and then rate all the songs at once. In this case, we've created a smart playlist that looks just for music that's rated 4 or 5 stars, and then sync that playlist to the iPod. Or you can use the song's comments field to add something like cartoons, create a smart playlist that looks for that comment, and then sync that playlist to your iPod. It's also a really good idea to know how to get to the iPod's shuffle command without taking your eyes off the road. If your iPod is playing, press the menu part of the click wheel a lot. This will take you back to the main screen. Scroll your thumb around the wheel several times to get to the bottom of the screen. Then scroll back one notch and listen for the little click sound that the iPod makes to move to the shuffle songs command. If you have the latest iPod Nano, you can take advantage of its voice commands, commands that will tell you what they are when they're highlighted. Just plug that iPod Nano into your Mac, select it in iTunes source list, and in the Summary tab, enable the Enable Spoken Menus for Accessibility option. Now sync the iPod. When you next use the iPod, you'll notice that a voice announces each command when you select it. And yes, that includes track, album, playlist, and artist names.
Flaming Red, Patty Griffin, Flaming Red, Flaming Red. Now playing.
So you ever drive along and you're listening to some nice little Chopin mazurka at a reasonable volume? Next thing you know, AC/DC comes on and blasts your ears off, causing you to swerve into a tree? Bad idea. Here's how to fix that. iTunes includes a feature called Sound Check. Its purpose is to analyze your music collection and tag each track with volume information. That information is then used so that all tracks are approximately the same volume. In iTunes 8, you'll find the Sound Check option in the Playback tab of iTunes Preferences. Once you've enabled the option, it will take a while for the analysis. Once analyzed, sync your music to your iPod. On the iPod, you'll find the Sound Check option in the Settings area. It's in the Music setting on an iPod Touch. FM transmitters are convenient for a number of reasons. You can use them in any car that you have access to, and some can also charge your iPod when you drive. But they have the disadvantage that they can be a distraction when you need to change frequencies. If you have to use an FM transmitter, be sure to get one that allows you to preset a few frequencies. Then go to the trouble of learning which frequencies are clear in the areas that you're likely to drive. Once you've found them, store them on the transmitter, and finally, learn how to change frequencies by touch. In the best of all worlds, you'd find some way to plumb your car for a direct connection. Your music will sound a whole lot better, and you'll be safer playing it. Any good car audio shop should be able to wire your car for an iPod for less than $200. Here's one final hint. If it's that darn important, pull over. Hope you found this stuff helpful. Thanks for joining me. See you around.